I said a while ago that I would do an overview of this omnibus. Now it's finally time. So let's look at Ultimate X-Men Volume 1. Alright, welcome back, everybody. So, before we get started, I want to mention why it took so long to make this reading order. Well, let me show you. So, this is why. This book is jacked up. And this was not my fault. Sometimes the omnibuses just come in like this. Like, I stretched the spine and did everything you're supposed to. This just happened. And so the book is, like, super jacked up. It's still readable. Like, I could still read it just fine. It's just, yeah, that's not pretty to look at. And so the book could fall apart. So I'm going to be careful with this video. I got to be super careful while doing this reading order. It's still readable. It's just not pretty and, you know. But the problem is the hole is too small to put the binding. Like, I have the binding glue. It's at my house. The problem is the hole is not small enough. The hole's not big enough for me to put the paintbrush in. So at the moment, I can't do anything about it. Once the hole gets bigger, if it ever does, then I'll be able to fix it. If it doesn't ever get bigger, then I don't know what I'm going to do. But it's getting bigger, I can tell. So we're going to be talking about spoilers in a little bit. But let's just get started. Let's take the dust jacket off. Got this great Adam Kubert photo here. Got the synopsis of the book. Got the creators, Mark Miller, writing all of this. I think, like, there's like a little bit of stuff not written by him, but Adam Kubert doing the artwork and Chris Bachek. Got your spine here, and then all of the covers. So this book collects Ultimate X-Men 1 through 33, and then the half issue, and Ultimate War issue 1 through 4. So you see right here, you got this awesome wraparound cover by Adam Kubert. Super cool. This is from the first arc, the Tomorrow People, I believe is what it's called. Alright, so we're going to get started with the spoiler review. If you don't want to be spoiled, what I always do is right here, I have the time for when I stop talking about spoilers. So if you don't want to get spoiled and you just want to see my basic thoughts, right here is when I stop talking spoilers. So, hello people who do not care about spoilers, who you've either read this or you just don't care. Got this David Finch artwork right here. Got all your table of contents here. So this is Ultimate X-Men. This is the first arc, the Tomorrow People, that I just thought was a great way to, like, introduce this modern take on the X-Men. So in case you don't know, the Ultimate Universe is an alternative universe, so things are completely different. Wolverine is a completely different character, and we'll get to why in this video. So you got, like, these Sentinels attacking, and so basically Magneto and the Brotherhood has declared war with the humans. And so Jean Grey is, like, recruiting Beast and Storm, Colossus. So this is the team. You know, you got Cyclops, Storm, Colossus, Jean Grey, and Beast. Wolverine joins in later. But the interesting thing is also Bobby Drake, but he appears in this issue as well. So the first assignment is to recruit Bobby Drake, who's 15. So again, things are a little different in here. But this is such a great story. I love this whole omnibus. A lot of people have issues with the Ultimate Universe. I get it. There are some things that Wolverine does in here specifically. Some character choices that a lot of people hated. I'll just say it, you know, he kind of tries to kill Cyclops over love for Jean Grey. I get why you don't like it, but I am able to buy into it because I know it's not actually from the universe. So they're doing something different, and I respect them for it. And it was shocking, so. So yeah, basically, Wolverine is working for the Brotherhood. He is recruited to kill Charles Xavier. So Magneto recruits him to pretend, you know, to become an X-Men and then kill Professor X. Oh, you have this great story, this little rescue mission in here. So the first arc is six. You can see that messed up spine there. But the first arc is six issues long. And it's just so much fun, and it gets even better from here. But this is just such a great way. Oh, and then you have the half issue in here that's written by Jeff Johns. just so cool. It's pretty cool. But I just love this omnibus. Like, all the stories in here, I just really, really enjoyed. And, like, the Return to Weapon X. Not to get confused with Weapon X, The Return. This is Return to Weapon X. And it's a little different, obviously. So you have the Samuel L. Jackson, Nick Fury in here. Oh, man, this is good stuff. Good stuff. Some dark stuff, and this is a dark story, but it's super violent, and I love it. Mark Miller is a pretty divisive writer, but I've always, you know, enjoyed most of his stuff. Haven't read Ultimates, but I love his X-Men. Okay. After Return to Weapon X, you have maybe the best story in this omnibus. This is the You Always Remember Your First Love. This is a two-issue series. Or not a series, but two-issue story arc. It's 13 and 14. Oh my god, it's so good. So this is Gambit on his own. It's about him, you know, he's homeless, and this girl, like, shows up, and he decides to protect her. She's homeless. Her parents were killed, and it's him having to rescue this child. That's all you see of him. He's only in these two issues, but oh, it's so good. He has to, like, rescue this child, and they kind of have this relationship. And then, you know, you get to see the X-Men become famous. You know, they're in magazines. People know who they are. Oh, and then you have, like, the world tour. A lot of characters getting reintroduced in here. Let me show you really quickly what the eye of the book is. Again, yours most likely won't be all jacked up. Don't not buy the omnibus just because this specific copy is jacked up. Not all of them are like that. This is just, you know, just sometimes this stuff happens. So the book is fine. It's just this copy happens to be messed up. But you got a decent eye there. The eye there is pretty good. You can see my book falling apart. Oh, God. You can see the glue, like, the glue. I guess it just wasn't glued well, because, like, you can see the glue falling off here. Dang. Can't wait to get that fixed, but again, not big enough yet. So you have some great artists on this book. Oh, yes, the anime issues that feel like an anime. But you have some incredible artists. You have Adam Kubert, and, like, the whole Kubert family comes here. Like, Joe Kubert, I believe? Yeah. Joe Kubert, and then, like, Andy Kubert. So, and then the Ultimate War, where they team up with the Ultimates, which is the Ultimate Universe version of the Avengers. So I just really enjoyed all these stories, dude. I thought they were a lot of fun. And then David Finch jumps into it. He's such a great artist that he joins in the book. And then you have this little backstory about Magneto and the X-Men right here, where it kind of tells how they, you know, kind of grown to hate each other. And I love, since the Ultimate Universe is so dark, they make how Professor X loses his legs like 10 times more messed up. Because this universe is just more dark. I mean, there's no other way to put it, man. So this is David. This is the last arc in the story. The last, and then after this, Mark Miller leaves the book. This is Return of the King. And it's illustrated by David Finch. It's so good. I love this stuff, man. Love all of this omnibus. But again, David Finch's artwork is so good. So freaking good. But, yeah, man. Oh, okay. So, right about here, we're about to get to the point of the thing that I think really started causing this book to get a lot of hate. And it's, I get it. Okay, so this is the, again, talking about spoilers. So, if you don't, you know, want to get spoiled. Okay. So, a little while ago in the book, Kitty Pryde, Wolverine, and Cyclops went on this mission in the Savage Lands. And as you can see, Cyclops is holding on to dear life. He's got Wolverine holding him, and he's like, Wolverine? So they're having, he's like, I never should have doubted you, man. Wolverine gives this little look, and he's like, Wolverine? And he says, guess again, bub, and then let's go. Tries to kill Cyclops. Juicy. Tries to kill him over Jean Grey. So again, different version of the character. So I didn't have an issue. This is not our Wolverine. This is a different Wolverine. So I didn't... I mean, look how messed up his arm. Again, it's super violent stuff. So, like, his arm is, like, his left arm is, like, over his... It's so disgusting, but it's great. So, Return of the King is a very fun arc. I really enjoy this stuff, man. I think it's a lot of fun. I just love this whole omnibus. And I will certainly be picking up Volume 2. They announced it, so I will be getting it. Oh, and then the final issue in here where Cyclops confronts... Because Wolverine got kicked off the team for obvious reasons. In the second to last issue. Cyclops comes to recruit him and say, come finish your term, or whatever. So, he lets Wolverine join the X-Men again. Cyclops was almost killed by Wolverine, and yet he lets him come back. And he gives Wolverine this ring that belonged to his wife, because Wolverine doesn't remember his past. And then, like, Professor X has this conversation with Magneto in here at the end, setting up the future for Volume 2. So while I'm looking at the variant covers, welcome back, you non-spoilers who don't want to get spoiled. So basic thoughts, I love this omnibus. Yeah, it makes a lot of changes, but I love it. I love the character choices, I love the artwork, and everything about it. So this is like a 10 out of 10 omnibus for me, honestly. Most people will not agree with me, but honestly, I could care less. Also, I wanted to mention... For the people who weren't watching the full video and, you know, you skipped the spoiler part, don't skip on this omnibus. If you really want this omnibus, still buy it. And the reason is this one specific copy just happened to be jacked up. Not all of them are like that. I've seen a ton of videos. I made sure to check that not all of them are like that. This is the only one I've seen that has a jacked up spine. So if you want the omnibus, you should still get it. This is just my copy because it's so much fun. Let's look at this these sketchbook designs. Imagine if Cyclops looked like this. I know it's an alternate universe, but if he looked like this, that would be too ridiculous. Much better designs right here. I don't know what that is. Then Jean Grey. This is funny. Just kidding, it's a joke. It would be great if this Professor X had a mohawk. Got Beast in here. Storm, Wolverine with his goatee. Gambit looks completely different. Sabretooth, Magneto, Thor, Nick Fury, all of them. So yeah, 10 out of 10 omnibus for me, personally. Ton of sketches in the back. Whole lot. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel. It helps a lot. So, hope you guys enjoyed. Again, please consider liking and subscribing to the channel. And I will see you sexy people next time. Bye-bye.